CUP stands for Commitment to Underserved People. It's a program that was designed to help provide service to the underserved populations of Tucson and Southern Arizona. What's unique about this program is that it's student-driven, student-run, student-organized, and student-managed. It's basically run by students. We don't charge for anything. We don't collect any fees, so therefore, it's all dependent on volunteer time from the physicians and volunteer time from the students. And that's one of the most important components of this program.
My name is Stacy Jaw. I'm a second year medical student. I volunteer with Shebitz Family Clinic and I'm one of the student in charges. As student in charge, we basically help run clinic from start to finish. It wasn't really until I moved to LA where I worked in a free family planning clinic. And I think while working there, it really showed me that sometimes a big problem is that they don't have the access to healthcare.
Ayuda mucho porque habemos muchas personas que no tenemos el dinero para ir a otros hospitales y no tenemos seguro y aquí nos dan esa ayuda.
And I think that kind of translates to the mission that University of Arizona Medical School has is that they want to reach the underserved populations. And it's really fortunate that there's such a big program here at U of A with CUP because it's the largest student-run clinic for underserved populations. And so it was really important for me to get involved.
We have 37 programs currently. Of those, 12 are what we call clinical programs, where the students volunteer their hours providing clinical services. The main clinics we have here at the College of Medicine are Shubitz Clinic, providing primary care to people who do not have any insurance. Mind Clinic, providing similar services to people that cannot afford psychiatric treatment. Women's Clinic, which is a clinic for women who have been subjugated to domestic abuse. And tot shots, which is basically vaccinations, immunizations for people that cannot afford those type of services in the community. So from day one, all these programs originate from students. They come to me with an idea, and if it sounds legitimate and it's going to be helping an underserved population, we authorize it.
The patients that come generally will come from places that are far away. I've heard people travel as far away as 8 hours, which is pretty incredible to realize that we are able to give someone this treatment and that they are driving 8 hours to come see us, which makes us feel like we definitely want to do a good job.
Los servicios que he recibido están muy buenos y la gente, los estudiantes, también muy, muy amables y con mucha paciencia y son buenas personas.
I was talking to one physician and he said he was older and he's like, you know, the best thing you can do is volunteer and kind of give back to the community. Like he said, he'd recommend doing it every single week. So, and it's cool to see someone, you know, so far in their career that is still doing this with all the benefits of volunteering and working. Another great thing is being able to work with the attending. So we get usually a different attending every single week and they are volunteering their own time. So it's really nice of them to come on a Tuesday night, even though they might have work or family. And you can just tell the heart that they have, and it's very inspiring.